Thank you. was very impressive this afternoon. He's got away from his markers and he has been very close to them. Senior has been very closely marked this
afternoon.
forward, Devinton again.
Thank you.
first one. Thank you. good game that we saw in the first 45 minutes. Support all the same.
18,627 euro and 47.
stop that.
Are you ready?
whistle towards him. Good position.
and the attendance this afternoon, 18,267, and a great majority of them are now going to troop off to Upton Park. Fraser Digby is with us right now. Two or three great saves by him.
It's going to be a tight game. Obviously, you know, a good first division team, and you know, we always knew it was going to be the odd goal that was going to win it.
But those chances, when Mark Moore came through, he had loads of space, didn't he, on the right hand side, and he just managed to tip it over them.
Yes, true. We got behind Paul Bowden and just tried to hold me ground because I knew Paul was getting back at him, and as he hit it. And, you know, I obviously got a hand to it and pushed it away.
Of course, it was a great ball when Ian Brady sent that up, and he had a great influence on the West Ham.
Oh, he's just a superb player. You know, he's got such a cultured left foot. You know, if you don't close him down, he's just going to be in trouble all the time.
But Swindon match West Ham itself, you know,
yes, well, that's one of our, obviously, one of our trademarks. You know, we match, you know, that's what we try to do, whatever we're lacking. Possible ability, we make up for in sheer hard work and endeavour.
In the replay at Upton Park, that's going to be a difficult ball game, as they say. Are we the precious switches slightly the West Ham
then? Yeah, obviously, we're going to go there as the underdogs, so obviously we can just worry them again, see how it goes.
Fraser Digby, well done, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.
Stu McCarry with me down by the players' entrance. Nil-nil draw against West Ham after Upton Park now.
Yep. I think that was our main concern before the game. We'd be a bit short of firepower up front. And I think on the day, had we had it going for us up front, we'd probably won the match.
Certainly no complaints about the way Swindon battled, though.
Oh, no. I think it's fair to say our lads have ran twice as far as theirs because they've got first division brains. That's why they're playing in the first division. You get in position before the ball comes. And because your brain tells you that, but to compensate that, our lads, as I say, worked harder than them, and I think over the 90 minutes, as I said, ran twice as much as them.
Much you said about Liam Brady beforehand, and I think he certainly lived up to his billing.
Well, he plays in a little area where it's very difficult to get at him, especially if you're a lively type of player like Steve Foley, where if he's wanting to get him down the pitch, I mean, Liam just sat there in the middle of the park, and I think every time Foley went forward, and he's quest for a goal, if it broke down, the ball would come out to Liam, and of course Steve was somewhere near the box. That little pairing didn't really suit us.
Because the thing is, he just appears to have so much time, doesn't he? Nothing seems to flummox him.
I think he's entitled to Vic. He's been a top player all his career, and he comes here and he's playing against a second division team. That's his main asset, and obviously that's what the West Ham manager wants from him.
Up front, Swindon battled away well, but West Ham had one or two chances, and Fraser Digby was there to pull off the important saves.
Yeah, we left ourselves a bit open at times when we were going looking for the winning goal. And I think you do that, especially playing at home against the first division side. You think, well, this is the best place to get it. You don't really want to go there on Wednesday night. And I think in our anticipation looking for a goal, we left ourselves a bit open in midfield and at the back. But all went well for us. You know, they didn't score a goal, and as you said, Fraser kept us in the game.
Right, Upton Park on Wednesday night then. It's going to be a difficult occasion for them.
No reason why they shouldn't win. Wouldn't hold any fears for me if I was going to Upton Park. They are a first division team. But on the day, if our lads work as hard as they did today, West Ham have got the power to score a goal. And we'll be sort of attacking on the rebound from when they're coming forward. And I think away from home, as you've probably seen yourself over the last month or a couple of months, we found it a little bit easier to score goals.
It's a similar situation in Norwich City last year, isn't it?
Well, I hope so, because we won at Norwich. But I just thought today we lacked a bit of height, especially up front. I'm not interested in what people tell me about kicking balls into big centre forwards. In English football nowadays, that's a big, big asset for you. And the teams that have got it seem to get results after results, whether people like it or not. Wimbledon have went today, and have went against Villarreal and won. That should tell people something. That team that keeps going has got height and strength and a physical presence about them. Probably what we're just lacking at the moment a little bit.
There was a big crowd here as anticipated and tremendous atmosphere.
Yep, we got right behind the team. long interest in their supporters, obviously. Got right behind the team, and I think they kept a few tired legs going, because there was a few of our players tired.
You'd like to see as many of them as possible at Wednesday night at Upton Park?
Well, we know there will be. There won't be as many, but we know that we'll have a good following there, and I don't think our players will let them down.
Lou McCauley, thanks very much indeed.
Thanks very much indeed, Lou.
Two of your keen supporters.
Not enough goals, though.
No.
Well, he
wanted one.
Yeah,
anyway.
Sorry. Really, very much as I expected. I thought before the game, in spells, we'd be chasing shadows at times because it's West Ham, first division players. Their trademark is good football. And not being disrespectful to our team or our players or any player in the second division, that's why the second division player is there and the first division player's at the top. But we compensated that, I felt, by the work rate. Most of the lads had to work twice as hard as the opposition because their brain was telling them where to go. Their footballing brain, that is. And as I say, I think we compensated well and truly by working overtime, really.
Do you think, I mean, in effect, you more or less cancelled out a lot of that skill?
That was the biggest asset before the game. If we didn't, as we saw late in the game, once you get them a bit of room when we began to tire a little bit, they can open you up. I just told our lads in there, that is the difference between first and second division players. And that would be the difference if you were playing in the first division every week. That type of game you had today would be every week, and probably, well, you couldn't cope with it.
Thanks.
Yes, we opened the match day ticket office, and I think at the moment we've got 480 tickets for sale. We sold, I think, somewhere in the region of about 160 at this stage. We obviously expect quite a big following from Swindon Town supporters at West Ham. Everything's not lost at this stage, and I've just been talking to some of the West Ham people, and they don't think it's a formality by any means, even at Upton Park. They're heavily involved in the Littlewoods Cup, and they foresee this still being a tough battle, but, you know, just the odds will perhaps still decide.
So how many tickets have you actually got available for Swindon people?
At this stage we've got 480, but I mean, must stress that you can go into Upton Park and there are room reserve tickets, and they've got plenty of capacity. They estimate at this stage they think they'll probably get a crowd in the region somewhere 18 to 20, although possibly I think they might be surprised on the night. They may get somewhere in the region of 24, 26. I think their ground capacity is 32, 34,000.
I think it's worth stressing at this point it's definitely not all tickets.
Oh no, it's definitely not all tickets. Obviously a second division club going to a first division and attract a capacity gate, unless probably you're in the sixth round of the FA Cup.
So when will the match day ticket office be open? Will it be open tomorrow?
No, it'll be open again on Monday morning. Obviously during this last week or so, you know, everybody's working long and hard hours, so they'll be glad of a rest tomorrow, but it'll be open again on Monday.
And you reckon you'll sell them out on Monday?
Oh, I would be surprised if we didn't sell the majority of those again.
Everything seems